Hey folks, this is Daryl Cagle. We're going to do another cartoon today. Doing this cartoon on a Friday, and Friday is probably the worst time, Friday in the afternoon, probably the worst time to draw a cartoon because the newspapers are going to close down and have all their stuff in bed for the Sunday editions this afternoon as everybody goes home for the weekend. So you don't want to send your cartoon out on Friday late, because newspaper editors aren't even going to look at it until Monday morning, and then on Monday morning they're going to look and say, this cartoon is old. We don't want to print an old cartoon. So I'll probably color this one tomorrow or go a little slow. I might release it on Sunday morning. The trick to releasing them on Sunday mornings that cartoonists are learning is that's how you try to get into USA Today on Monday. Because they want a cartoon to look new that people haven't been running on the last Friday. So, as I'm in this new spot, I find that I misplaced my sandpaper. So I went outside and I grabbed a couple of rocks. I've got this rock and this rock. They look like perfectly good rocks to me. And we'll see if they work as well as the sandpaper. I'm guessing they will not, but I'll have to make do today with rocks. It's like the cavemen, when they used to draw political cartoons, had to draw with rocks. Okay. I'm seeing some trouble with the stream on Twitch. That's unfortunate, because I don't know how well this new location works with Twitch, but we'll just have to find out. So, this is the cartoon for today. This is my little note to self. This is a two panel. Panel one, panel two. So here Republican Elephant says, everything is fine with the Trump campaign. And reporter says, okay, now speak off the record. And Elephant says, it's a disaster. Great big mouth and jump lines and excitement things. Hello, no red ties. You write, new studio and new lights. Overhead under face lamp gives you a different glow. Good rocks. Yeah, I'm not sure the rocks are that good, but I'll have to do with the rocks. And yes, new studio, new lights. We'll see how all this newness works. I'm interested to know if you guys have good streams going. So tell me if the stream is working for you, because mine seems to be stuck. Don't know if it's working or not. All right, so I want to do a two panel. So let's start by bifurcating. And maybe the first panel needs to be a little smaller. Let's do that. Put our break right there. And here's a... I'm going to make them not quite as big as I usually start off with, because I'm afraid they're going to get bigger as I keep drawing it. Nice to see you here, no red ties. Oh yeah, I refreshed and now it seems to be working. It doesn't seem to be too far behind. I think everything's good. I think with this lighting, I'm looking a little bit green. Not sure I'm happy with the greenness. Well, go with what we got. Things are generally working. I suppose that's all I can ask for. Generally working is good. Hand gesture. Not sure if I'm going to keep that or not. No red ties says the stream is great. That's good. Nice to see the stream working. Considering I haven't tried this before, I'm on Time Warner Cable here, which I have never tried in a stream before. I did get their very expensive service that is supposed to be fast and should give me no trouble. But you never know. You know, I think I am going to delete that. This is the editor sign for delete. Little, I guess it's a little sideways Christian fish. Is the reporter. This is an old-fashioned reporter. After all, this runs in newspapers, which are pretty old-fashioned now. Press on his hat. I like to draw inquiring reporters as expressionless, although he'll have plenty of expression in the second panel. Hey, no red ties. How is the sound? Is the sound good for you? Turn it up a little bit. You know, they're too big. I thought I was drawing them small, and I wasn't. So I'm going to start over. Make them smaller. Smaller elephant. And smaller press guy. May still not be small enough. Elephant needs to come down a little more. See, notice as I draw, they always get bigger. Getting bigger as I draw. Let's move me a little bit this way. That's a little better. Press guy needs a notebook. I like to give them a hat, old 1940s hat, so that I can put the press card in the hat, which was kind of a standard. And oh, hey, Wilson Walker, thank you so much for following. I appreciate that. So the hats like this is kind of a cartoonist standard back in the 40s, 50s, 60s. And I like the hat with the press card that says press in it. Seems kind of charming. Throw back to the earlier days for the elderly readers of newspapers who are the ones who will be looking at this cartoon. As I'm often reminded by you guys in the chat window, I must be the oldest guy on Twitch. Here I am on Twitch drawing for newspapers. Bloody hell. And I'm using rocks to draw for newspapers. Jeez. Caveman cartoonist, any way you look at it. Like that new big arc in Kentucky. cartoonist on the arc. That would only be, that would be less than 6,000 years ago, though. I went to visit the Creation Museum in, what is it, Williamstown, Kentucky? Yeah, it was an interesting experience. I wrote about it on my blog. You can go look at the blog, you can see some pictures. Daryl at the Creation Museum. So no red ties, how is my sound? Is the sound okay? Okay. Elephant says. Reporter says. Everything is fine with Trump. Campaign. I might bring that down a little bit because I'm getting a little tall. Break here. One thing you can do that's kind of nice in a two-panel cartoon, Snorlax in your pants. Nice to see you there, Snorlax. Snorlax, I need follows. Come give me a follow. So when you have a two-panel cartoon, you don't have to draw both panels. You can draw a box around one panel, and that's all you need. That defines the two panels, just one panel. Can narrow it a little bit, have them poking out of the panel. Let's have that go there. We have a little bit of crosshatch texture that I'll probably put up here at the top. Give it a little bit of pop for the balloons. So I think elephant needs a little more sanguine character to his body language, because we've got a contrast with him being excited in the second panel. So eyelids and half mast, a little bit of disinterest. I'm not sure I like that. Let's come back in with another pencil. So let's get the eyelids in sync here. Get him looking at this guy. Alrighty, that looks kind of fine. He's a little nonplussed. Looking fine. I'm going to want to keep him in the same scale in the second panel. because I don't want to change perspective. That just would distract from the gag. This is kind of a long-lasting cartoon. I think this cartoon is going to be good for a few days, so it doesn't really much matter that I'm drawing it on Friday. Drawing it on Friday because I only did one other cartoon this week on Monday. I'm dealing with all this moving stuff. And I have not been drawing my quota. Back to my quota. Plenty of news to draw about. I don't really have anything special to draw about the Olympics. The Olympic Committee, about in 2009, I think it was after the 2008 Olympics, the International Olympics Committee in Switzerland hired me to draw some cartoons for them. I drew some Olympic cartoons, and there was one that I thought was my best one, that they killed, it bugged them. I drew a guy that was getting tattooed with the logos of all the Olympic sponsors. Big muscly athlete getting his Olympic sponsors tattoos. And he had a great big Coca-Cola on his chest, and I had it say, had a guy walk in the room and say, "Hey, they just switched sponsors from Coca-Cola to Pepsi," but he just got his Coca-Cola tattoo, and I thought that was kind of funny, and he didn't like that one bit. Olympic Committee. Other than that, it was a nice job. I'll have to dig that cartoon up sometime. People are always interested in what cartoons got killed. Killed cartoons. Probably not supposed to show that one, since that was a freelance job rather than an editorial cartoon job. And they bought the cartoons that they didn't use, and they probably don't want me to show that one. I thought it was funny, though. You're not going to hear any mention, not even any jokes about Pepsi at the Olympics. They can't tolerate jokes about Pepsi. I don't think they would have printed any jokes about Russian athletes doping, either. But back then, that was not an issue. My feeling about doping is that these guys live such crazy, immoderate lives anyway. And they all want to dope. And what the hell? They want to wreck their bodies for a few extra points. It's fine with me. Maybe they could have a doping Olympics and a no doping Olympics. Except you wouldn't trust the no doping Olympics because you'd think they were all doping. But if they had a doping Olympics, everybody would trust it because everybody's doping. It might be better, more interesting Olympics. Everybody doping. On the other hand, that's probably what it is right now. So it might not be any more interesting. Might be just what we have now. Anyway, I would let them all take the dope. Libertarian Olympics, huh? You guys say nothing. Babbling on like the oldest person on Twitch. Okay. Okay, let's give him some better footing on the ground. I think the elephant needs a little more width. And I'm going to bring the speech balloons down to there. So, there. There. Good enough. I could have his arrow going there and his arrow going there. See if I like that later. All right, panel two, which is the action panel. Let's do that. Remember, this is everything is fine with the Trump campaign. Okay, now off the record, it's a disaster. So, big mouth saying it's a disaster. Big crazy tongue. Let's do that. If I can get his arms in front of him. Then I can have him bigger in the frame. Trunk is kind of funny with the tongue. Some bent legs. I want this to seem like he's stretched rather than changing perspective. Can do more interesting stuff with the trunk in this area of the middle, so let's do that. I may want to resize this down to match the height of that one. No red ties, right? So I was working for 15 minutes. Can you go back? That's an invitation for me to explain to you that all of my videos are available at darylcagle.com for the cartoons that I record as these live streams. And this one will go up when I finish the cartoon and it has gone out to papers. And you can watch all the stuff that you missed on this and any other live streams. And you can watch it at 2x speed on YouTube, which is twice as interesting. Let's give him some grit teeth. Not as much emotion as the elephant, though. His hair blows. Sense. I don't need a speech balloon for this, I don't think. If I did, it would look like that. Maybe that's kind of funny because that goes in through behind his trunk into his mouth with his tongue coming up this way. Maybe that's funny. Here I can have his tie flying too. Tie flying is kind of funny. Let's see if I can fix this up a little bit. A little bit of rock. Get some pieces of the rock. Okay. One thing that I like to do to make people look a little more crazy when I'm going for a crazy look is to make the eye that's farther away in perspective the bigger eye, because that looks a little bit wrong. If it was smaller and the farther away eye, it doesn't look so wrong, and it doesn't really work that way. Make the farther eye a little larger. That's funny. Going to need some upper lip here and some teeth, I think. Let's get rid of that. Give him a little bit of shade under his big proboscis. And this ear. Pretty wild. He's looking kind of appropriately crazy. You can go with that. Not quite sure what I'm going to do with his arms, I think, until I'm done with the reporter. A little bit of the same thing with the reporter. His far eye is bigger. Back to my rock. Maybe I've got a better finishing rock here. Oh yeah, finishing rock. Ooh, speck of water. I'm gonna give him real teeth. Real teeth meaning not just a grid, but think of where the canines and the bicuspid starts. Draw those correctly. No red tie rise. Appropriately crazy takes one to know one, I should know. So you're kind of crazy, huh? Well, I've had a few people commenting on here who I thought were kind of crazy. I would not count you among them. Alright, I think he looks same scale than appropriately. This one is more squash and stretch. Star Kark. Alright, so how come none of your elephants have tusks? You know, there are cartoonists, editorial cartoonists, who draw their Republican elephants with tusks. And, I find that the tusks are a distraction because I want to get a nice mouth going for the expression. And I can't, I think, in any circumstance come up with a tusk that adds to the expression. You know, the tusk is supposed to be static. It's a bone. It's supposed to be in the same spot. And so it doesn't really, I think, give me much to work with. And it takes up a nice space where I'd like to do something different with his mouth. So, you're right, I avoid the tusks. I could do tusks. There are some cartoonists who do tusks. And they look okay, but I think even for those cartoonists, they'd look better if they didn't do the tusks. Oh, Comey, nice to see you here. Any possibility to draw some cartoon about how much people Trump and Hillary attract to their speeches? Well, I don't know. Do you have any suggestions for that? Interestingly, when I get suggestions from readers about cartoons they would like for me to draw, very often, most of the time, those suggestions include my drawing a crowd scene, and sometimes their expectations of what I can draw in a crowd scene are just ridiculous. You know, draw the sky filled with helicopters, and on the ground there are two armies. It's like Game of Thrones. Put a Where's Waldo in. Thousand people on the ground, hundreds of helicopters in the sky. I actually get people writing, say, put hundreds of helicopters in the sky. Jeez. Trump gets much bigger crowds than Hillary. Well, I don't want to draw a cartoon that shows a big crowd. Trump complains that the press doesn't like to show his big crowds. But I'm just too lazy to draw it. Also, if you did draw it, if I did spend all the time drawing all those little people, cartoon would be lousy. Because simpler cartoons are better. That hat looks a little bit wrong, doesn't it? Let's give him his press card. Okay, elephant. It's do a little lowercase typographic A. It's A. That I even need an exclamation point. It's a disaster. I want the letters to nest a little bit so I can get them bigger in the space I have allowed. Nest letters, nest. Yes. That hand, let's give him. I'm gonna move this hand up a little bit so that I can show the opposing thumb. If it wasn't up a little bit, you wouldn't see the opposing thumb. Yeah, you know, the stream is looking pretty good here. It's going fast, it's not that far behind. I think our tech is working here. Idea post-it that suffered for being in my pocket. Let's give him some spittle. Spittle amuses me. Typically in the mouth you don't get past the bicuspid. Okomi writes, "So Daryl, I hear Trump is afraid Hillary is going to rig the vote. Is that even possible?" Sure, it's possible. Suppose Hillary had a brother who was the governor of Florida. And Hillary's brother, the governor of Florida, appoints a crazy radical Republican Secretary of State responsible for certifying the vote, and she just decides who won the vote without really recounting or looking at hanging chads or anything. And then it goes to a Supreme Court with only 8 members on it, whereas if it had 9 members and it And a Republican majority, it could pick the Republican to win, but now it's got only 8 members and it's short of picking a Republican to win. You know, that kind of scenario kind of works. I kind of like to make the ties poke out below the jackets a little bit. I think this is kind of where I want it to be, although I think I might do a little squash and stretch in Photoshop to get them lining up just where I want them to be. Let's just put another hand over here. He can have his pencil in the air. Kill that. Looking right, give him some squeal lines. Can emphasize that with hey, thank you so much, Kiana Piranha. I appreciate the follow. Okay, I think I'm just about ready to move on to drawing the finish. This kind of looks like it's where it should be. I think I'm going to make this first panel tight, very tight on them. That'll give me a little more room for all the squeens in the second panel. And then I'm going to squash this to match the height of this panel. Or else I'll stretch this panel. Actually, this guy's looking bigger, so I should stretch this panel. So remember to stretch in Photoshop. All right. Let's set this up. That took me an hour. An hour! Bloody hell. Looks like it shouldn't take so long, doesn't it? Everybody thinks. Excuse me, I draw much faster than I do. No, it takes me an hour. Friggin' hour. As I look at it, it seems like I'm drawing fast enough. See if I can get some chisel points going here with my rock. No sandpaper today. I have rocks. Drawing like an old caveman. This guy on Twitch, you know, I was drawn with the dinosaurs like they show at the Creation Museum in Kentucky. They show the old first political cartoonists drawing with the friendly dinosaurs looking over their shoulders. The good old days of political cartooning. All right, let's put that over there. I think this reporter needs a little bit more character. See what we can do with it. Eyes are the issue. A little bit of lack of focus in the eyes makes him look more surprised. There's his top teeth. No Red Ties writes, the ties on elephants should be red. No Red Ties, you have boundless irony. Hey, how is my sound? Is the sound here okay? Do I need to turn it up? Change it? Bring it down? I'm gonna give him a little more thoughtful ear going on here. I'd like to have a little bit of... sound is perfect. Oh, thank you. Kian Piranha writes, what's the advantage of the rock for sharpening over sandpaper? The rock is not as good as sandpaper, but I didn't have any sandpaper, and I did have rocks outside. The advantage of rocks over sandpaper. That's kind of funny. Hello, Peg. I'm broadcasting here. I am broadcasting. I should put a sign on the door. Okay. Can have a little 5 o'clock shadow. He looks appropriately horrified. Phantom Blights, nice to see you here. See if I can fix this hat. I need a little more rock. Alright, let's fix this hat. Press Fedora. I wouldn't mind if the press was required to wear fedoras. I know, you're not supposed to regulate the press, but a regulation I would support would be fedoras. That really makes me sound like the oldest guy on Twitch. Okay. So here.
I've got the problem of being close to the edge. Looking like a hat? I guess enough. Perspective on hats are always kind of sketchy. No red ties rise. Rocks are better for defensive situations than sandpaper. Do I not have the chat showing up on the screen? Chat, chat, chat. Don't think the chat's showing up. I will have to address that at a later time. One thing I like to do with crosshatch is just make the line a tiny bit thicker in areas where you know you've got shadow, instead of actually drawing a shadow, just the plain lines looking a tiny bit thicker. So his hands on his notepad have a kind of hot potato, don't quite want to touch this aspect to them. Here's his pencil. Give him a bit of crosshatch on the notepad. This is the back of the notepad. Okay. Move this hand down a little bit. All right. A little bit of rock here. You see my rock? Thank you.
Drawing on this an hour and 12 minutes. I can put this whole leg in shade. No red ties, right? I like that you have two rocks for which you have specialized their use. I use pens, so I'm jealous of the rocks now. Rocks, let's try this one. Guys like that I'm using rocks. You know, the sandpaper is really quite nice and the rocks are kind of lousy. But I suppose they're funny. Phantom Blight writes, does the rock sharpen the pencil like a knife? No, it sharpens the pencil like a rock. Silly question. Fascinated by my rocks. Okay, that's looking right. This finger looks a little bit wrong, but wrong in a way that amuses me, so I'll go with it. I should do the lettering last. Oh, you want to see my rocks?
dark on the far sides of those lines to give it a little bit of sense of curling around the three-dimensional trunk. Crazy Claire, nice to see you here. Thank you for the kind words. You need to follow me. I really need the follows. Thank you so much, Crazy Claire. I appreciate the follow. Very nice. Yeah, with this one, I think I'm going to color it tomorrow because I probably don't want to release it till Sunday. I'm gonna do a second cartoon tomorrow. See how it goes. I like that the streaming here is working so well. Crosshatch inside of his mouth to emphasize the coming out of his mouth. So that's why that direction. Not very good. Buds on his tongue. Thank you. Dogs have gone silent. I'm definitely going to need to stretch this one up to match that one. I might drop this one down a little bit because the elephant's looking too much bigger and the reporter's looking bigger. But then again, whenever I draw something, everything gets looking bigger. So I'm going to have to see how the one on the left turns out. His feet are got a little tilt towards each other. It's kind of nice. Thank you.
the sandpaper, I just go zoop zoop, and it's done with the sandpaper. I have to fiddle with it. No red ties, right? So we never get to see the sandpaper, so maybe that's why we're fixating on the rocks and you brought the attention to it. Yeah, I usually have the sandpaper off to the right. Not much to look at on sandpaper. Sure, I like this S, but it's kind of frantic and disturbing. As is that letter A. I think that last one's not a rock at all. It's a scrap of stucco.
roster. Okay. Maybe that's enough for this panel. It's a disaster. Okay, now off the record. I haven't quite decided where I'm going to put those balloon arrows. Everything is fine with the Trump camp. Oops, you like to see my rocks. Actually, the rocks slow me down over the sandpaper. Sandpaper is better. Okay. Looks kind of like a reporter. Thank you. So if you folks want me to talk, you should ask some questions. I was watching on the news about how all these unnamed sources among Republicans and the Trump campaign are just apoplectic about how everything's going, but you don't ever get them saying that on the air. But they don't mind having that go out to reporters off the record, unnamed sources. Excuse me. Been drawing for 1 hour and 47 minutes. Alright, that would not have taken so long if I was using sandpaper. Okay. Let's pad down a little bit. His shoes, or wait just a second, make the shoes and the shoes on the elephant look like they're on the same ground. I should probably wait a second and do that, huh? Eyes a half mast here for this first question. Notice that as I crosshatch, I think of the three dimensionality of the character beneath. I think of them as being three dimensional. Then I make my crosshatching exist on that three dimensional surface. Nothing too technical is going on here when I'm drawing with a pencil like this on a piece of vellum. But I do get lots of questions from cartoonists about how I choose to color the cartoons. And of course, I have my own procedure that I'm comfortable with, and it's not how you have to do it, and people do things in different ways. But when you watch my coloring videos, which are always separate from the drawing videos because it takes me some time to scan and prep for the coloring, you'll see them all posted on darylcagle.com, and you will get a little lesson on how I prep the cartoons and format them and do the coloring and layers in Photoshop. And some people, a couple of cartoonists, have been emailing me complaining about the videos that they don't think they can see clearly enough what I'm doing in Photoshop. So when I do this one in color, I'll try to explain a little bit more explicitly just what I'm doing in Photoshop. For those of you who are confused and say it just goes too fast, doesn't seem too fast to me. An hour and 54 minutes. Let's give him his tie sticking out down here. That amuses me. This is going to require grayscale. I haven't done the suits black. I haven't done the stuff people are used to me doing with pinstripes. I like drawing pinstripes, but I typically like to do the pinstripes and all the textural stuff in the suits when there's a simple cartoon that needs more detail and crosshatch. Which is not the case this time. This one has, if anything, too much detail and crosshatch. Okay, now let's make his shoes look like they're on the same surface.
see my pencils here. Those are the used ones that need another sharpening. I've been told that my sharpening is very disturbing and I should do it in advance and have lots of pencils so that I'm not ever interrupting for pencil sharpening. So that is what I do. Pencil sharpener really is quite loud on the video. As I draw these shoes, I'm thinking of them three-dimensionally. I'm thinking of where the light comes. I put off doing them for a minute so that I'd get them on the same plane, looking like they're both on the ground equally, the elephant and the reporter. Do for these balloon arrows. Let's give him one here. Give him one here. So that kind of works, huh? Silent viewers. Drink made a wet spot. Think about how I handle this first panel. I think this first panel is going to stretch up and down. So let's give the top of it a little bit behind the balloons.
Okay. I'm not quite sure how I'll do that with color in the grayscale, but I'm guessing that I'm gonna. Hey, a tasty sandwich! Thank you for following. I didn't notice that. I should have looked up half an hour ago. Okay, I think I've just about got that there. Let's put signature in an inconspicuous place. And where do we want to put politicalcartoons.com? I'm going to stretch this down a bit, so putting it there, which would seem to be the obvious thing to do, not quite obviously what I want to do. Put it up here. This is a bad place, politicalcartoons.com. Maybe over here. All right. I'm thinking this is done. This is, this is the finished line art, and I think tomorrow morning I will do the color of this. This little bit of a confusing place down here is going to be cleared up by tone when I put grayscale in here and color. So all will be clear. Friday. I think that is complete. So, thank you for joining me today and hanging through this whole thing, if you did hang through the whole thing. And keep an eye out for me tomorrow to color this, and I will see you later. That is the end of part one. Part two shall come in just a moment. Thank you very much, folks, for joining me today.